Hi, welcome to the Additional Exemptions Rundown. In this module, we're going over the extra homestead exemptions, what they're about, who qualifies, how they work, veteran considerations, and a case study at the end. So there are extra exemptions that can increase the standard exemption by $500 or $5,000. There are also 100% exempt options too. Here's a short list of some people that may qualify. Ultimately, the idea behind all these extra exemptions are to help Floridians out. For example, if someone is a widow or if they are legally blind, they could put in for the additional $500. If somebody is a disabled military veteran rated 10 to 100% or an unmarried surviving veteran spouse, they can put in for the additional $5,000. And for the 100% exempt, meaning you pay no property taxes, here are some of those examples. Permanent disabled first responders, fallen hero, unmarried surviving spouses, and other permanently disabled people like certified veterans or their surviving spouses and people with limited incomes. Keep in mind, many of these additional exemptions come with all kinds of stipulations. The 100% exempt options are rare. If you apply for any of them, be expected to provide a variety of different supporting documentation to your local property appraiser. Also, many guidelines are Florida specific, therefore preventing out-of-state transfers. For example, let's say an unmarried surviving veteran spouse from another state, they won't be able to qualify for this additional exemption because their survivorship occurred while living outside of the state of Florida. To all my veterans out there, there's one area that causes a lot of confusion. It comes down to what kind of VA letter you have. One letter gives you the additional $5,000, while the other letter gives you the 100% exempt. Just realize, not all veterans who are rated 100% disabled are certified as permanent in total. Go ahead and check out the example letters I provide below. In my case, as a disabled military veteran myself, I have the additional $5,000 exemption. That extra exemption helped me save about $700 for my first 7 years. If I didn't have that extra property tax exemption, I would have paid closer to $37,000. Here's what it looks like in a graph. There you go, module 3 complete. I'll see you in the next one.